Welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be doing a bit of a review and tutorial on the new... First off, I'm going to get it out of the box and show you guys what the palette looks like and kind of first thoughts and all of that stuff. And then the second part will be me doing a look with it. So I'll timestamp somewhere down here if you just want to get straight to the tutorial. If you want to go ahead and watch the whole thing, then keep on watching. As always, don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. It means the world, so thank you very much. I will just say, if you see a ginger thing lurking here, then it's my cat. Okay guys, so this is the package that I received. I ordered this on the 12th of January. As always, it just comes in a little black box. I'm not going to show you the front because that's where my address is. So yeah, let's open it up and see what's inside. Okay, so as you open it up, this is what the inside looks like. It's a little bit bigger than all of the other boxes that she usually sends her stuff in. I guess that's because the palette is bigger this time. It's got the packing shipping reference. This little postcard, which is super cute. So this is gonna be the look that I am gonna try and recreate today. And just a message on it. So, here it is. It's much bigger than the other palettes, which I'm kind of excited about. It also feels a lot heavier. So yeah, so this is the outside packaging. You can see on the back, it's got the kind of colors marked out. So let's go ahead and open it up. This packaging is really, really cute actually. Ooh, so nice. Actually, already the weight of it is definitely something that stands out. So this is the size of it compared to what her other palettes look like. So in this one, her previous palettes, I think there's nine shades, and in this one there's 12, so definitely getting more. I will say this newer one, the peach palette, cost me $45. This one cost $42. So for an extra $3, you're getting an extra 3 shades, and also there's a brush inside too. The only thing I will say is on the back of this, it says the burgundy palette. I don't know if you can see it. Whereas on the back of this one, it doesn't say anything. It's just got the shades and Kylie's signature. So definitely good value for money, depending on what obviously the quality is like, but we'll go ahead and see. The first thing that I'm like really intrigued to see is whether it smells. There's been loads of videos saying that this palette has a really strong kind of chemical odor. So I can't smell anything yet, so. So nice. So it definitely smells of chemicals. It's not as strong as some of the kind of really extreme YouTube videos that I've seen, but there's also been loads saying that their palette doesn't smell at all. It smells like glue. I think if I had to hazard a guess, it probably isn't anything to do with the eyeshadows. I imagine it's something to do with the packaging. But mine's not too strong, but you can definitely smell it when you get really close to it. Anyway, so this is what the palette looks like inside. It's got a lovely big mirror in, which the others don't have. I believe the Holiday Collection did have a mirror, but I didn't actually get that one. So it's nice to get a little mirror in there. So here are the 12 shades. So beautiful. Of course, you get the brush inside this palette as well, so we'll go ahead and see what that is like. So the brush is super cute. Just take it out of the packaging. Just white rose gold with Kylie on it, and just a really fluffy kind of blending brush. So I'm definitely going to use this in the tutorial today. Okay, the colours that really pop out to me is these three along here. The blue, of course. Definitely a strong odor. So this costs $45. Obviously they do free international shipping over $60, but shipping in itself is $15. So you can either just pay $15 for shipping, or you can get free shipping and spend an extra $15. So in that case, I went with a lip gloss, one of the ones that I haven't got, which is so cute. If it goes together, I'm gonna be using these two, just why not? So let's get into putting it on our face. Okay, so to start off, I'm gonna go ahead and do my eyes first because it's gonna be using quite a lot of powders. I don't want it to fall out onto the rest of my foundation. I am not gonna do a flick, but what I am gonna do is try and make it really precise just using the shadows. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take a little bit of sticky tape. I am just going to mark out along the eye where almost a flick would be. So to do that, I'm just going to almost measure it out from the edge of my eye to the end of my eyebrow. So I'm just going to take the sticky tape. To make it a little less sticky, I'm just going to pat it on the back of my hand and pull it off a few times. I want it to be sticky, but I don't want it to be completely stuck to my eye so much that it's going to pull too much. So I'm just going to go ahead and just stick it along the edge there of the eye, just to give me that really kind of refined flick. Just pat it along the top, just to make sure that none of it is lifting on that bit that you need. I'm gonna go ahead and do that to the other eye too. The key is just to make sure they're even. That feels a bit weird underneath the eyes. I'm just gonna peel that back a little bit and let it kind of lap around. Okay, I'm just gonna go and clip my fringe back, because that's gonna get annoying. To start off, as always, I'm gonna go in using my MAC Painterly paint pot just to set the top of the eye. And of course, using, you guessed it, my concealer fluffy buffing brush. So I'm just gonna pick a bit of product up on there and dab it all over the eyes. Using this tape is great because ultimately at the end, what you should have is a really straight kind of like winged line, but without it being with a liner. So if you're not confident in using winged liner either, or you just want a more subtle look, this is perfect. So if you haven't tried it, give it a try. You can use loads of different tape, but this is just what I had. It was just kind of standard little mini ring of sellotape. Okay, so let's get started with the palette. So I'm gonna start off, and I'm gonna use this as much as I can just to give it a kind of true review. Like I said, I'm gonna try and stick to this, but almost do my own version as well. So just to set and just to add a little bit of color to the eyelid, I am gonna go ahead and use this color here. The colors, it's really hard to tell what way round they are, but Royal is third in, so I'm gonna guess that this is Duke. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and use this one on the brush and pick it up. Just checking that it doesn't smell, it doesn't really smell of anything. So already quite good payoff, quite a good pink pigment on there. I'm just gonna go ahead and kind of sweep it all over the lid, especially paying attention to the crease. The brush is good quality, but already if I just pop it on the back of this, it's like starting to fry out a little bit. We'll see how it holds up. So I'm just going to pick up a little bit more product and just go into the outer corners, just really laying it down ready for the darker colors. Next up, I'm going to go ahead and use this color over that peachy colour, just going straight to the end. And right down to the lash line. You can already see how this is going to kind of be when the tape comes off. This colour's really pretty, but it is much more orange than what it looks like in the little pan. This brush is definitely feeling good, but like I said, every time I look down at it, it's like an extra hair's kind of wanting to run away. There's a tiny bit of shimmer on there, so I'm gonna go ahead and use a combination, I think, of two kind of bronzy shimmers. This looks quite green in the light, but it is more of a copper kind of shimmer. So I'm gonna use these two. Next up, let's go ahead and pick up a shimmer shade. I might even do this using my finger. I'm gonna go ahead and pick up this one first. Not bad. Okay, it's definitely more flaky than the kind of shimmers in the Burgundy palette. Brush like I did say I was gonna do and see if that makes a difference. So there we go. Slightly kind of pat it and pack it on. Very interesting. I think this might be better to be used as like a glitter with glitter glue or like Max Fix Plus or something like that, which I might try. Okay, let's go ahead and use the other glitter anyway. So I'm gonna go ahead and use this one now. I'm gonna start off using my finger. Sometimes with eyeshadows, it's almost got like a surface layer on it. So sometimes when you scratch that off and kind of break through it, what's underneath is much better, kind of more creamy and pigmented, but we'll see. But already, if I just show you this on my finger, you can tell. I mean, the pigment's definitely there, but it's much crumblier. Let me just show you to compare. So this one is from the Burgundy palette and this one is from the Royal Peach palette. So you can see this one is quite crumbly on the top, whereas the other one is totally smooth. This one definitely seems to be a little bit more intense and almost like a cream though. And that is from the Burgundy. This is from the Royal Peach. Interesting. Now I need to clean my hand. Just gonna take the other colour now and dab it on. Go right down to the inner corner. Okay, so yeah, definitely a different kind of shimmer. Not as pigmented or as creamy as the Burgundy palette. Last but not least, I'm just gonna take a different brush. I'm gonna use a kind of angled contour fluffy blending brush. I'm just going to dab back into this darker colour here and the kind of bronzy one that's above it. I'm just going to run that along the wing line and into the crease. Again, along the wing line and into the crease. Meeting the glitter in the middle. So just taking off any of the glitter and all of that that's on there. I mean, it's weird because the colour's still on there, but the glitter, there's like no glitter on there, but I packed it on. How strange. Anyway, okay, let's just blend. This is Ginge. It's another one of my cats. Say hello. They're kind of matching, got that orange vibe going on. Okay, so for now, I'm just going to bring you in a little bit closer so you can see what we've done. We've kind of got this flick that hopefully will reveal if all goes to plan. That's kind of how she's got it here. So she's got the glitter kind of in the middle part of the eye. What I'm now going to do before I take this off, I'm just going to put a coat of mascara on and then we'll take it off. Okay, so as always, using the Voluminous L'Oreal mascara, I'm just going to go ahead and coat the lashes. Okay, so I've just popped a little bit of mascara on. I'm gonna go ahead and just very, very gently just pull this away. Meow. Perfect. And now what I'm gonna do with a makeup wipe is just go around the cheek area. just make sure that that's completely cleaned up. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and do my foundation. I'm gonna be using the L'Oreal Pro Glow. This is gonna be in the shade 203. I'm gonna go ahead and just pop that on now because you guys don't need to see that. This is kind of mainly about the eyes, so I don't want it to be too long. I'm gonna skip parts like my foundation and eyebrows that you guys have seen before and just stick to the kind of focus being on the eyes. So I will catch you in a second. And I'm gonna pop this on. Okay, now my brows and my lashes are on. I have used Anastasia Beverly Hills Brow Wiz in dark brown for my eyebrows and Coco Lashes Queen Bee on my lashes. Okay, so now it's for the exciting part. It's gonna be under my eyes. In the image, you can kind of see she's got the peachy color and then she's got the blue color on top. So I am gonna go ahead and try and keep that the same. I'm gonna use a tiny little brush from Real Techniques and just start to pick up a little bit of the brown kind of shades, tap that away, but also mix in with the peach. I'm literally just gonna run that along under my eyes. So I'm just gonna pick up a bit and show you guys actually. Okay, just gonna swatch it on my arm to show you. It's kind of chalky and crumbly. I'm just rubbing it in and this is how it's gone. Just try it again. Okay, so I've picked it up on my finger. I'm just gonna rub it in. It just doesn't transfer well. Like, I've got so much on my finger that it's like clinging. This is gonna be interesting to try and copy this. Wish me luck. Let's go in. That's a bit better. Just really put, like, packing it up on the brush. I mean, it's definitely cute, but the quality is not what I imagine it to be. So, I mean, it's there on the brush, you can see it, and if I just try and transfer it to the back of my hand, I mean, that was, it's like there on the brush, you see that? I'm not going crazy. I mean, so much up, it's like almost mounded, like a mound on the brush for me just to dab it on the eye. Okay, now I've laid that down, I'm gonna go along with this Tarte kind of pencil brush just to blend and buff it together so it doesn't look so crazy. Going along that lower lash line. I mean, you buff it a little bit and the color just starts to disappear. Okay, let's go ahead and add mascara to the lower lashes. Okay, so this is how the eyes are looking at the moment. I mean, the top's really pretty. The blue is just like, just expected more from it, do you know what I mean? I'm gonna go ahead and just do the rest of my face. Now for the lips, I'm gonna use MAC Strip Down and the Kylie So Cute Gloss together. just to give it a bit more of a nude lip. I think that the eyes are pretty full on, so we don't want to take away with kind of dark lip. I guess you can do whatever you want, but I think for me this is going to be the best kind of look. So let's just add this. So this is stripped down. And just for extra wear, I'm just going to try and coat my lips with it as well. So I've put that over most of the lips, and I'm going to go ahead with my more nude shade. I've not used this one before, I've used the other glosses, so I'll be interested to see how this comes off. Okay, just gonna dive a little into the lip. The brush I find to be quite restricting on these, so I'm just gonna pop that back in now I've got the product on my lip and use my finger just to pat it in. Brush is just a little bit too thin, and just kind of push the product around. Always find if you pat it in, it gives you a little bit more of a fuller look. Okay, so this is the finished look. I think that I've tried to stick as close to this look as possible. Overall, I think the palette is okay. If you take the Sweet Peach Too Faced palette, I hate to say it, but I think this is probably better value for money. I am really intrigued to try and do a look with these bottom colours. I think they're really, really cute. Again, the colours are beautiful, I just think they're a little bit chalkier than the other palette. And having loved the other palette so much, I've mentioned it in my top 10 beauty buys and all of that, I really loved it. But I just think that the quality and the price, I mean, it's not my favourite. It's not my favourite palette. As far as this look is concerned, I think you could easily do the blue with a blue eyeliner. And the gold tones and the peach tones that come with it are pretty generic, I hate to say. I think if you do want a peach palette, I think the Too Faced Sweet Peach palette might be a better shout. The variety is amazing. You do get more shadows. The smell is amazing. It smells of like amazing peaches. I think this is good, and I seem a little bit cowardly because it does look good on, and I am enjoying how it looks on. I just wanted a little bit more from it. I wanted the blues and the golds to be a little less chalky and a little bit more creamy, which is exactly what you get with this palette. I think Kylie's other palettes have been amazing. I definitely think that everyone should have this palette if they're into makeup and they're into these shades and they're looking to get a Kylie palette. I'd probably point more towards this one than the others. I do think it's a super cute look. The only thing that I'm not sure on is whether the pros really outweigh the cons. The cons being that obviously you've got to wait quite a long time for it to arrive. It's kind of expensive. It's $45. You're needing to pay $15 to ship and then £17 in custom fees. I'll let you do the math of that. When you can get the Sweet Peach palette, £39 at Debenhams in the UK, or if you're overseas, obviously Sephora and every other place will do it. So yeah, I'm definitely going to try and do a look with the other colours in this because I think they're stunning. So definitely watch out for that. If you've got the palette, or you've had it, or you've tried it, or you're interested in getting it, comment down below. I'd love to know what you think about it. If you've got yours delivered and it didn't smell or did smell, comment below. Like, tell me. I'd love to know. I'll tell you what I will say is I am loving this lip combo. So that's definitely a plus. So I hope you guys found this interesting. Whether or not you're into Kylie Cosmetics, you can't deny that on the whole, 99% of the products are amazing. I will try and use the other shadows and I'll keep you updated with what I think. I'm just saying it how it is. Just saying it how it is. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll catch you in my next video.